Hello everybody, this is Theron. Welcome to the Minecraft 1.9 Snapshot Tour. We are here, and you might notice a couple things. I have no armor. Yeah, there's a story there. I also haven't recorded anything in a few weeks. I was getting ready to, and busy. Sort of post-holiday stuff, and spent a couple weeks on jury. Oh hello. Oh shoot, get away. I don't have armor. This is bad. Wow, I've never seen one of those before. Let's see if I can take one of them out. Oh, I don't want to kill the horse. I wouldn't mind keeping the horse. Oh, don't kill the horse. Oh, interesting. Okay, so they're not super deadly. I can pick them off with a bow. Oh, I might be able to get myself a horse here. Oh, not, don't kill the horse. Oh, that was quite a lag spike there. I need a place to put the horse. Let's go find ourselves a horse. Hello, how are you? I've never seen that before. Can we go somewhere? Oh. I need a saddle. Do I have a saddle? I might. Ooh, sun's coming up. Hurry up. Let's go. Oh, I don't think they'll burn up in... I don't know if they'll despawn, though. Do I have a saddle? I might. Oh, I do. I have a couple. I have three. Let's take them. Let's go. Hello, guys. Oh. They changed all the sounds. So the iron door sounds super wimpy now, which is interesting. Hello, horsey. Oh, shoot. I did not mean to do that. Sorry, it's this trackpad. And, oh, saddle. Oh, hello. Nice. What do I do? Let's bring him down over here. Doesn't have a ton of health, but maybe we can, fix that. Let's go see if we can get the other guy without hitting him again. Or her, whatever the case may be. That skeleton is still sitting there. Oh, this one's got a ton of health. Nice! I got me a skeleton horse. Oh, okay. Oh, I like that they eat the grass. I have a lead over here. I can go make more. Let me grab. Oh, I have two leads over here. Let's go grab some fence posts. And let's see if we can tie them up. And I'll. Maybe that's something we can do. Build a little barn. I didn't really need to come up here. They changed other sounds as well. I guess the furnaces now. Oops. Furnaces now make a weird noise. They changed the trapdoors. Wood. I just need a couple of fence posts. That'll work. And let's go tie. Oh, geez, you scared me. Okay. Hey, guys. Let me do this. Let me put. We'll, get to recent trials and tribulations in a bit here. I have business to do. Can I? Can I not? Interesting. Hi, dude. Oh, man. So I can't put a lead on them. Okay. So let's go get some materials here and make ourselves a little barn. Suppose I should eat while I'm at it. What would be appropriate? What kind of block should I get? I can always replace them. Let's just get some stone. That's good. You're a zombie. Uh-oh. Okay. So, where are we going to build our horse barn? The horsey barn. Let's do this. That emerald that I have in my pocket, that's the only emerald I have left. It's part of my tale of woe. And I will get to it in a moment here. Hi there, dude. Please don't call your friends. We're on a hard dough, so you probably will. Oops. Ah. Learn how to build. So. Will that be enough? Yeah, I don't know if I like this new trackpad. It is not making things easy. All right, so build this up. Oops. And of course I don't even have a pick. Okay, I have to go get that pick. This is annoying. Don't need, oh, okay. Oh, go. Okay, let's go. Hop on you for now. Put you inside. Yep. Out of there. Go get the other guy. And they can share for now. Oh, this is the one I want anyway. Come on. Woohoo. Thank you. And I'm just gonna block you in, because that way everything will be fine. And then we'll come up here. Oh, I made myself a little stairs. And let's put some light in there. How do I not have torches? Oh, come on. Okay, let's go get some coal. Let's make some torches. That skeleton guy's still hanging out over there. Not anymore, he's not. Okay, coal. I think I keep coal in here now. Yeah, I've got some coal here. And I've got sticks, so I can make what I need. No problem. Wow. So, I wonder if that was just complete happenstance that I happened to come across the skeleton riders, which have been in, they've had snapshots in for a while now. They've been in the snapshot for a while now, but that was the first time I've seen one. My impression was they were very rare, and do that, and do that. And I'll figure out how to deal with these guys, because that'll be really cool. A horse I can ride around on. A skeleton horse. That's even better. Okay, so Tales of Woe. So I went into the end to do some prep. Oh, I've got a couple of these guys in here. Huh. Oh, I'm not really in any shape to take them on. So, I went into the end. Wanted to go explore other areas of the end island. And because I haven't tested if I can resummon the dragon. I should do that. And maybe one of the last things I do. Oh, hey, dude. Oh, you have yourself an arrow. Yeah, come here. Yeah. Couple arrows, thank you. Went into the end. I'll do the dragon fight again at some point here, because I should. But went into the end kind of cautiously and decided to try bridging out to another section of the end island, another area of the sort of ring of end islands. Look for another end city. I got going pretty well, but then I did something extraordinarily stupid. And I was under the impression that they changed it. So, hang on, I can demonstrate here. Let me pick up these experience orbs. That when you... it used to be that when you crouched, if you brought up your inventory and went away, you were no longer crouched. And I thought they had changed that so that you stayed crouching, so you could go into your inventory and still be crouched. And so thinking that that was the case, I went, okay, can we see it, the uncrouch happen? Yes, you can. Oh, that's frustrating. So I just literally, I put some more stone bricks on my hotbar, left, thinking I was still crouched because I still have the shift key selected. I went like that and fell off my bridge, which was, of course, over the void because I was bridging between islands in the end. And I fell into the void and I lost all my stuff. Shouldn't have been wearing all my good armor. Shouldn't have brought all that stuff in with me. So I now need to... Well, they changed that sound too, didn't they? I now have... I need a bunch of books now. Like, I need... Probably going to end up having to replace this sword before I get there, but this is literally the only emerald I have left. I think there's one on an item frame over there on my little chest, but, you know, the best sharpness guy I have is 58 emeralds, which is super expensive, but I need a bunch of mending books, and I need a bunch of protection, I need to do a bunch of enchanting. It's really frustrating. So, so I've been kind of doing maintenance here. I've trapped a couple more guys. I need to do some more. So I got a guy with Depthstrider 3, which is nice, but there's a few things I'm missing. Like, I don't have a power book, or I have power 3, so I had to combine a few of those. That got expensive. So I need to... it's very frustrating. And I don't have a good armor librarian. I don't have, you know, and I don't have a, I'm breaking 3 librarian. So I've got this power 5. So I was able to fix my, I was able to do up my bow. So super frustrating. I have a cheap infinity guy. So that was great. That helped with the bow. But anyway, I need more emeralds. Whoa. What the heck happened there? I didn't touch any of them. Dude. That was so not cool. You still upset at me? I did get smacked, but yeah, I got smacked by one of the Iron Golems. I didn't hurt anybody. You gonna try and get me? Wow. I don't think I smacked any of the villagers. I didn't mean to. Certainly. Oh man. Okay. Let's get out of here just in case. So anyway, I'm very much in rebuilding mode here. Don't have that much progress to report. I have made progress in the building my little end road. Not that I found another end city or anything. I wonder if I should check and see if these guys are still in there. Do they make noise? Yes, they do. Okay, good. Oh. So anyway, I don't really have much else to talk about. Actually, I do. I don't want to linger on too much, but The last couple weeks, I said I've been busy. The reason I've been busy is on jury duty. Which, oh, ender pearls. I don't have any ender pearls. That would be useful. I think I have some down here. So if you're in the United States or another country that does things in a similar manner, you get called up potentially as frequently as once a year to serve on a jury for trials. And, you know, it's inconvenient and sort of disruptive to your life to get called up. And LA County does a pretty good job of judging how many potential jurors that they need at any given time. So basically, you're on call for a week, and you get you basically call in once every night during the week, and you get so here's the books that I have. I'm ready to go. You get called in, and you can basically, you dial in or you log online and you say, I'm checking in. And then they're like, oh, well, come in tomorrow at 7:45 a.m. or 6:40 or whatever it was. It was early. Early for me anyway. So then you show up and then you sit around and then they randomly call the people who are there. If there's a court room that needs a jury. And then you go in for jury selection, which is a whole complicated process. And if you end up on the jury, I mean, there's a good chance that you won't, but if you end up on a jury, then you end up showing up and listening to testimony and deliberating with your fellow jurors and deciding on the guilt or innocence of the defendant. And it's, I don't know, people complain about it a lot and like to try and get out of it. And it was, you know, somewhat inconvenient timing, but I've never been on an actual jury before. I've only gotten to the jury selection process once. And in that instance, I was dismissed from the jury panel. So this time I actually got on the jury, and it was a fascinating process. And I should probably just put all this armor on so I don't get myself killed by the Iron Golems anymore. So it was a criminal trial, and in the end, I'm kind of glad that I was there, because it was very enlightening about the way our criminal justice system works in places where maybe it doesn't work so well. And and we had a guy who, I think, personally, I think got overcharged, and I think the prosecutor had a very weak case. And so I'm glad that somebody was there. There were a couple of us, but we're there to make the argument that maybe the case wasn't so strong. We ended in a mistrial. We could not come to a unanimous decision, which is necessary for a criminal trial in the United States. So I don't know what's going to happen to him. He could get retried. He could get released. They could change the charges. There's lots of options at this point. And I probably will never find out what happens to him. Which is disappointing. But I'm glad that, because it was a felony, a violent felony case. And California has this three strikes law, where if you get arrested or convicted of three violent felonies, they can basically send you away for the rest of your life, even if the penalty for the third, even if the penalty for the third conviction wouldn't have, you know, been all that much. And this may well have been, I don't know. And we weren't supposed to take it into account anyway, but this might have been a third strike situation. I don't know. So, anyway, that was all interesting. And tiring. Sitting around all day long listening to people talk, contradict each other, and ask annoying questions. It's all very, it's exhausting. So, and it took us a lot longer than I think anyone expected it to take. It took us 3 days just to get through jury selection, and then we deliberated for, we were there for a total of 9 days. So it took 5 or 6 days of deliberation, and as I said, we ultimately couldn't come to a decision. Which is good, because at least from my perspective, because at least it meant he wasn't convicted, he wasn't judged guilty on a weak case, which was my primary concern. So anyway, that was interesting. So I'm going to figure out what to do here. I'm a little nervous of going into the end, because they still seem to have the issue where sometimes you get, you enter the end in the, just the completely wrong place. But I do want to build an Enderman farm, because I want a better supply of Ender Pearls. And I still need to, I mean, I've kind of explored this stronghold, but there are other strongholds that might be interesting to explore. And in the Nether, I definitely need some sort of a blaze farm, particularly since the potion brewing now requires blaze powder. Oh, and they still haven't fixed this. Wow. Anyway, so that's that. Another thing, my nephew, who has a YouTube channel called StarTac Films, or he may have changed it. I think it's now StarTac Gaming. He's been doing YouTube videos, and they're really cute. And he's doing a couple series, and I actually appear in one or two of them. So I'll link to his channel in the description. Okay, I really don't need this aggravation. So I'll link to that in the description. I think it's really cute. And we've been playing on his, he has a Minecraft Realms server. Wow, that's kind of loud. He's a Minecraft Realms server, so we've been playing on that. And he's my wife's brother's son. And so I finally got my wife to decide she wanted to go play on his server. She doesn't want to play on mine, but or she didn't want to play on mine. So she agreed to learn how to play Minecraft. So we've been playing, I have a Realms server as well, and we've been playing on there. And just super basic, you know, teaching her how to play Minecraft so she can go on StarTac server and actually get by and not just constantly die. Oh, hey, zombie bridge. So we may record some content on there. It's, you know, it's Realm, so it's a 1.8 server. It's not 1.9. Oh, he's heading for the village, of course. Making a beeline for it. Interesting. So I may do some of that. But we'll I'll get more up to speed on rebuilding my stuff. And we'll go back into the end and hopefully find an end ship, a whole end ship, not that little crazy half end ship that I have. That I found, but we'll find a whole end ship and go play with that and get some elytra and fly around with those. And I have to build a barn for my skeleton horses, So I've got stuff to do. So we'll be working on that. And also, it is February, and last February I used Minecraft to make my RPM challenge record. RPM challenge is a challenge for musicians to make an album in the month of February. I've been doing that for the last several years, and I plan to do it again this year. I have some things, some plans in place, and I'm at least partly going to use Minecraft for that again. And so I may record some of me building and testing on that. I have an interesting idea. It's very different from what I did last year. So I may have some videos of that. And I'm once I get it all built and actually recorded, I'm sure, or you know, do record the audio, I'm sure I will record a video of that as well, because it's the same setup that I use for recording off the computer. Hello, Mr. Creeper. Yeah. All right, so I think that'll do. Didn't get too much done, but I have some skeleton horses now, which is pretty cool. So I'm going to work on that, and I'll record some more later. And of course, this is today's snapshot. Today is September, February 3rd, 2016, and I'm playing Snapshot 16W05A. I don't know what changes they made. They added a bunch of sounds, which is pretty cool. Oh, do I have something that I can smelt? Real quick, I want to hear the sound. I have some raw chicken. Yeah, let's smelt some raw chicken. Oh, it spits. You can hear the fire. That's kind of cool. Super subtle. Okay, that's kind of cool. All right, well, thank you very much for watching. This is Theron, it's Bang Splat, and this has been Minecraft 1.9 Snapshot Tour, and I will see you next time. Bye.